Let's take a look at this example together. So we have a company that pays a base rate of $20 an hour plus $10 an hour for the hours worked. Okay? So it's very important that you know how to work with word descriptions. Lots of teachers like to test you on this. You're given a word description, you're asked to do certain things with it, come up with the table of values, the equation, the graph, and that's what we're gonna see in this example. So in part A, we wanna first identify the independent and the dependent variables in this situation. So again, we have a pay, there's a base rate, and then there's the pay per hour. So what are my variables here? What am I interested in measuring or counting? Well, I'm interested in measuring the amount of pay, right? I wanna know how much I'm gonna get paid. And my boss is interested in measuring how much I work. So there's two things that we're measuring here. Some of you guys might be thinking, well, this base rate thing, what is that? Is that a variable? Well, variables are things that we're using to keep track of numbers, right? We don't know exactly what it is. It can change over time. But this base rate isn't changing. It's $20 per day, it's set. The amount of pay is changing depending on the number of hours I work. So this base rate is not a variable itself, okay? So the independent variable is going to be the number of hours worked. The employee picks how many hours they work. And based off of that, the dependent variable is going to be the amount of pay based on how much they work. So I'm gonna give these some variables. Let's call the number of hours worked our X and the amount of pay Y. You can use any letter you want, but I'm just gonna use X and Y because that's what we're more familiar with. All right, in part B, we want to create a table of values for the situation. So I'm gonna have my X and my Y, my independent and my dependent variable. Now I wanna fill out values. Remember, independent variables, those are the numbers that we pick. Well, X represents the number of hours. First of all, can I have negative number of hours? No, number of hours starts at zero and it can only go up. So I'm actually gonna pick my first one to be zero. And then I'm just gonna pick nice numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. If you really wanted to, you could have picked 2, 4, 6, or even 10, 20, 30. My only recommendation to you is to make sure that your X values or your independent values go up by the same amount every time. It will make your calculations that much easier and that much nicer. All right, now let's fill out the Y values. Let's calculate the dependent variable. So if this person worked 0 hours, how much are they gonna get paid? Well, regardless, they're gonna get paid a base rate of $20 an hour, even if they don't work. So if they didn't work, they don't get that bonus $10 an hour, so they're just getting paid your base $20. How about if they work 1 hour? Well, I get my base pay, plus on top of that, I get $10 for that 1 hour that I worked. So in total, that's $30. What if I work 2 hours? Well, $20 base pay plus $10 for every hour I work, so that's $20 coming out of the work, so that's $40 in total. What if I work 3 hours? $20 base pay plus $10 an hour for 3 hours, that's an additional 30, so now I'm at 50. And finally, at 4 hours, well, I'm getting $20 base pay plus $40 on top, so that's $60. You can keep going if you want, but generally we just want enough numbers in this table of values to give us a sense of what's happening. All right, in part C, we wanna create a graph based on this table of values that we created. When it comes to a graph, I need my axes. I have my horizontal axis, which is my independent variable, X. Remember, this is the number of hours that this person worked. And then I have my vertical axis for my dependent variable Y, which is the amount that we get paid in dollars. Okay, so my X is going up by 1 every time. So I'm gonna start at 0, and I'm gonna go up by 1. How about my Ys? Well, I'm not gonna start at 1, 2, 3, 4, because my first number is already at 20, then it jumps up by 10 every time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually draw my axis based on tens. If you're given graph paper, use graph paper. Your graph will be that much nicer. All right, now let's put in the points. When X is 0, Y is 20. So when X is 0, Y is at 20, I get this point right there. When X is 1, Y is 30. So X1, Y30, that brings me up to here. Okay, when X is 2, Y is 40, do the same thing. I get a point right there. When X is 3, Y is 50. And then finally, when X is 4, Y is 60. Okay, so I have all my points there. Now all I need to do is connect them with a straight line, and I get my graph. All right, part D, we want to write an equation that represents this situation. This is where most students struggle with. They're okay with the table of values, they're okay with the graphs, but a lot of students, me included, when I first started learning this, had a hard time with writing the equation. I'm going to recommend don't think about it in terms of variables and numbers. Think about it in terms of actual English. I'm trying to find out how much I get paid, right? So the pay is calculated based on the base rate. I get that $20 no matter what per day, plus $10 an hour for the hours worked. Now it's slowly coming together. I'm slowly seeing a shape in my equation. I'm going to try to replace these long words with variables if I can. What represents pay? Well, remember, we decided that pay was going to be the dependent variable and we represented that with y. Okay, so I'm going to replace the word pay with the letter y. Instead of saying, okay, pay is calculated based on, well, pay is the same thing as the base rate plus the number of hours, right? So in this case, if it's the same thing, that's going to be an equal sign. And then I have my base rate, which is $20, I can drop all my units, plus $10 an hour for each hour worked. Well, how do I know how many hours I worked? Well, again, we set that as our independent variable x. So I'm going to replace, instead of saying for the hours worked, I'm going to replace that with an x. There you go. Y equals 20 plus 10x. This is our equation. Now, in part E, we want to determine whether this relation is a linear relation or not. You have three different modes to represent this relation. You have your table of values, you have your graph, and you have your equation. From the table of values, you can calculate the first difference by subtracting the consecutive y values. If you do that, you'll notice that they're all constant, they're all 10. Since these first differences are constant, we know that it's a linear relation. Or we can look at the graph. The graph is just a straight line. So right off the bat, we know it's a linear relation. Or you can look at the equation. In the equation, our independent variable x has an exponent of 1, so indeed the degree is 1, meaning that it is a linear relation. So from all three scenarios, we found out that this is indeed a linear
relation. Hey guys, my name is Jess, the head of education here at WISE. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. If you want to see the complete course, please check out the link in the description. You can also go to one of our playlists to keep learning for free. If you want us to cover a specific course or a specific topic, please leave us a comment below. We post new videos every week, so don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the new stuff.